What is going on YouTube? It is Flawfish here and welcome to NHL 13 Tips and Tricks episode number 3. Today we are going to be covering one-on-one dekes and L2 dekes. So first off, we are starting with an L2 deke, a spinorama. This happens from pressing the left trigger or L2 and moving your right stick from either the 3 o'clock to the 9 o'clock or the 9 from the 3, whatever way you want to spin. So right here, coming in with Ryder and going to pull a spin deke off here and get a nice little scoring chance. It's something that, you know, you can pull off in tight situations too, which I did here, and it's very, very effective, especially when entering a zone or as I did there. It really helps in changing your momentum so you can pull off a deke after, and that's probably one of the best uses for it. On to the next deke, which is one of the L1 dekes, and everything from here actually will be the one-on-one dekes using the L1 or left bumper. So right here, I'm going to freeze it right here. So you can kind of see the two players on the other team. They're both user controlled. They're chasing at me, and I'm going to load my deke here. And by loading, I mean just kind of shoving the right stick out to the side here and then getting ready to press L1 here. I've already pressed L1 right now, and then all I have to do is move my stick over to the left here, and it's going to do a windmill deke. That's how you do it with lefties. With righties, you'd go left to right, you get the point, and get in the attacking zone. Almost get a shot away, don't know why he dove, but nice little deke to have. And using these dekes, you'll see another one here. You'll see the nice little stall here, as I like to call it. Using those dekes, you can kind of gain entrance into the zone and you can gain puck control. And when you have puck control, you can do stuff like this where you can get into the corners. You know, bit of a lucky play to get it in the corner, but nonetheless, it happened because I entered the zone in a different manner. And that's what I use these dekes for. I'm not like 100% pro at all of them. I do like this one. This has to be my favorite deke, as it seems like your shot right after it gets a little bit of a power and accuracy boost. I'm not sure about that, but it feels like that. When you score on one of them, it's pretty unreal, but using them entering the attacking zone is something you definitely want to take note of. It varies up your pace on the play. It kind of changes things up so your opponent doesn't get too used to you. So if you carry the puck in a lot and he starts to charge at you, don't be afraid, you know, to pull out one of these nice little one-on-one dekes here and score a beauty goal, like Jager did there. It's just one of those things to have in your arsenal, really fun to use, and honestly, they're very, very helpful, and they're one of those things that if you really want to do well in the game, you need to learn the basics of them. You don't need to learn, you know, like the behind the back and stuff. Those ones are really cool. Even I can't pull off the behind the back one. I have a very tough time doing it. I don't know if it's just my lack of coordination or something, but I can get the basic ones down pat, and the basic ones are the windmill for me. The top ones are the windmill. There's one that's a cut to the right side if you're a lefty, or to the left side if you're righty. It's just a nice little cut. And then there's the skate to stick, like you'll see upcoming here. And then there's the jump, and then I guess the fifth one would be the spinorama. I do like the spinorama. It's not technically a one-on-one deke, but it's one of those that I would definitely use if I were you. It's really, really helpful, and it's just, once again, it's another thing that kind of switches up your momentum, in which this game is heavily based off of. So using those, you should be able to enter the zone fairly efficiently and effectively. So here's probably one of the best goals I have ever scored with a one-on-one deke. It is going to be the skate to stick and just kind of nice little waltz around, and these are why they're so effective. They are really, really good at getting around diving players, and you can see that most of, like, a couple of them were around the diving players, you know, the nice little diving poke checks with their players. They work really well at shielding the puck so that you're hard to poke check, and poke checks are really effective in this game, and they also protect you from hits a lot of the times. If you guys want to check out some of the harder dekes to do, I highly suggest you check out a few places. One is nhlguides.net. They kind of have a whole bunch of guides going up there. I think I have a couple tutorials up there. And check out also Bones on Demand and Halo Diego. I think they both did deke series, and I'm going to try to link them below, but they're pretty good at them and they know what they're doing. So highly suggest going and seeing them. Some of the videos, I think Halo Diego has all of them in one video, so it's definitely very good to watch. As far as NHL tips and tricks go, I need your advice for next week. There's a couple topics I want to talk about, like kind of line strategies, cycling again, because to me that's something that really needs to be talked about in this game, because it's so good. just like it last year, and I find it very effective, as you can see here. I think I'm either going to do cycling or line strategies or defense or something you guys want to talk about. So let me know in the description below. And also, just a nice little update here. I am coming out with an NHL of like weekly podcasting, and that is going to be debuting on Friday, and that is going to be featuring NHL 13 gameplay and me talking about hockey for a good, I don't know, half hour to an hour. So definitely look forward to that, guys. Very, very excited to do that. But anyways, guys, as always, links are in the description below for the song. If you guys want to follow me on Twitter and, you know, just kind of listen to hockey stuff, I tweet about it a lot. It's in the description. If you like the video, leave a like, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Anyways, guys, this has been NHL Tips and Tricks, episode number 3. It has been on One-on-One Deeks. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Take it easy and peace out.